It's Thursday, May 28th. Protests demanding justice for George Floyd spiral out of control overnight. Businesses in our community looted, buildings burned. We captured this video near 27th and Lake Street, where an apartment building that was under construction was taken over by flames. People nearby using buckets of water to try to stop those flames. And new this morning, we're taking you inside the protests. Images of protesters comforting each other after being pepper sprayed. And this picture, two protesters raising their fist while standing in front of a barricade. We have team coverage as this story unfolds. Ellery is live in Mobile 11 with more. What are you seeing as you cruise the streets this morning?
Yeah, hey there, Chris. You know, from the video that you were just showing, I mean, and the pictures, it's just been chaotic here in Minneapolis overnight. So right now we are driving in Uptown, and which is, you know, several blocks away from where all the fires are still happening right now. But, I mean, it's hard to kind of see out our window, but from our vantage point, I mean, we are seeing smashed out windows, large windows of businesses like Verizon and T-Mobile and Urban Outfitters. We're seeing graffiti sprayed along a lot of these businesses as well. So there's, I mean, the damage just stretches far out here into the Uptown area as well. I want to show you video from yesterday and how this all kind of escalated. Take a look.
George Floyd!
Stop the system!
George Floyd! George Floyd! George Floyd!
So you can see protesters chanting George Floyd over and over as police officers are lined up to block them. Now, the protests started out peaceful, but some people turned violent overnight. Then the looting started. You can see people running in and out of some local stores. There are broken windows at a liquor store, for one example. People even hit up a Target on East Lake Street, just trashing that store. Now, in all of this, Minneapolis police is investigating a homicide. They say it happened near Bloomington Avenue and Lake Street. Officers were called to the area last night and found a man lying on a sidewalk and say he was shot and he was taken to HCMC and died.
We've had a number of fires set. We've had a good amount of looting, or a bad amount of looting, actually, just widespread civil disobedience. And it's unfortunate. It's sad. If people are there, truly there, to honor the memory of the decedent and the family, this isn't how you do it. And It's so disrespectful, and it's heartbreaking. It really is. It's people are utilizing this as a purpose to just make bad decisions.
Yeah, so I don't know if you can see, but way off in the distance, we are along Lake Street right now, but off in the distance, you can see smoke still billowing up from the fires that are happening in that immediate area. Governor Walz is asking people to stay out of the area of Lake and Hiawatha. Obviously, that is something that we are doing right now, staying away from that area. But we will be driving around kind of in the Uptown area, checking on things, and we'll check back in with you in the next half hour. Chris.
Well, thanks for sharing that, Ellery. Ellery McCardo reporting live from Mobile 11 this morning. And just into the newsroom, the mayor's office confirming they have requested support from the Minnesota National Guard. We spoke with Minneapolis Mayor Jacob Frey on the phone about the unrest. He's calling on everyone to keep the peace and honor George Floyd's memory. And when we asked the mayor if he had a message for Minneapolis police officers, here's what he had to say.
What you see is that those who are protesting peacefully get lumped in with those who are not. Police officers that are doing their job with compassion get lumped in with those that are not. And, you know, this is a crisis on top of a crisis, and, you know, pandemic followed by, of course, this really tragic killing. And throughout, you know, the last 6 weeks, you know, yeah, our police officers have been working their tails off. And so we need to be able to hold these truths in our heart at the same time, which is that the individual, the officer that horrifically killed George Floyd, We need justice there. It needs to be held accountable, and I've said that again and again and again.
Several businesses on Lake Street have been either damaged or destroyed. Gordon Severson explains how many of the owners have been out all night patrolling their property. A tense night for many, Gordon. Well, we're having trouble getting in contact with Gordon, but many of those owners didn't expect things to get this bad. They've seen break-ins, fires, and cars stolen from body shops. Many of these owners have put their hearts and souls into their businesses, and that's why many spent the night out in front of their business protecting it. Some owners were even carrying guns to try and scare away the looters. Others simply stood in their parking lots, hoping their presence would convince looters to walk away. Even some homeowners felt the impact of the destruction last night, with the heat of nearby fires shattering their windows.
Once we noticed the windows started cracking, we evacuated. We knew at that point the house could easily catch on fire at any moment, especially with the siding melting as it was, and it was getting really intoxicating, and just the fumes from it, you know, really got to your head.
For many homeowners, police say you have a right to protect your property, but the state's castle doctrine, they say, does not offer the same protection for business owners, so they're urging business owners to not take the law into their own hands. Some of the protesters overnight seem to forget the man at the center of the cause, George Floyd. Alicia is diving into the man behind this national story.
We all know his name because of, unfortunately, this tragedy, but there's so much more to him. He's now only living on, though, through his legacy, through memories of his loved ones. George Floyd, he was a father, a brother, and a partner to Courtney Ross for the past 3 years. She tells us everybody knew him as Floyd.
Floyd could take anyone and lift them up and lift their spirits without even knowing. He wouldn't want me to cry. He don't want anyone to cry. I can feel his arm around me right now.
Yeah, my heart breaks for her and everyone involved. Floyd actually moved here to the Twin Cities, rather, from Houston, and he worked as a security guard at Conga Latin Bistro, where the owners there tell us he was more like a brother to them than an employee. Now, Floyd, he leaves behind two daughters and siblings who loved and adored him. And Chris, as I mentioned, he was originally from Houston, Texas. We actually reached out to his former football coach, his high school football coach, who had only wonderful things to say about Floyd. We're going to hear from him coming up in the next half hour.
Yeah, such a sad loss of life. Thanks for sharing more about him, Alicia. The protests and looting fueled by this viral video showing the final moments of George Floyd's life. You can hear the words, "I can't breathe," over and over while an officer was on top of him with a knee on his neck. Initially, police said Floyd had physically resisted officers after they responded to a reported forgery in progress. This new cell phone video appears to show the moment Floyd steps out of the vehicle. Look at your screen. You can see two officers restrain him. Then this security footage from a nearby business shows officers walking him across the street in handcuffs. It's not clear how much time elapses or what happens between when this video ends and the moments before Floyd's death. The city released the names of the four police officers fired in connection with Floyd's death. The four officers are Derek Chauvin, Tu Tao, J. Alexander King, and Thomas Lane. Multiple sources confirmed to Care 11 that Chauvin is the officer seen in the video kneeling on George Floyd's back. Minneapolis Mayor Jacob Frey is calling on Hennepin County Attorney Mike Freeman to charge the officer who held his knee on the back of Floyd's neck.
How could I not speak out when an offense took place that you or I or many other people through our city would have been behind bars if they did? Yet this particular individual, this officer, was not.
Right now, there are two investigations going on. The Bureau of Criminal Apprehension is investigating the death. They'll bring their evidence to the county attorney's office, who will decide if a homicide charge is warranted. And then there's the FBI investigation. They're looking into whether the officers violated the civil rights of George Floyd. And new overnight, the University of Minnesota cutting ties with the Minneapolis Police Department. The university's president, Joan Gable, says she made the decision after, quote, watching the appalling video. She's referencing the arrest of George Floyd. As this story keeps developing, stay connected with Care 11 for updates. We'll bring you new information as we learn it on air and on all our digital platforms. Let's get you caught up on the weather right now. Clouds this morning as we look at downtown Minneapolis in the background. By the time people get done with work, Laura, will they be all gone?
They will be all gone. A nice bright afternoon. It'll also be quite windy, though, this afternoon and evening. So that might alter how much time you want to spend outside or what you do outside. Right now, dew points are on the decrease as our temperatures are headed up. It's much drier, more crisp air headed into place. The clouds will stick around here on, and we'll still get some peaks of sunshine through them through the morning hours. But this afternoon, lots of bright sunshine, windy, as I mentioned, and 77 degrees before it turns a little cooler for the weekend ahead.
And as the sun is up now, we can see still flames along Lake Street. This is the traffic camera, 94 at Highway 55. I'm still seeing a lot of flames and smoke in that area. Again, that's due to the riots and protests along the Lake Street area. So again, don't go in that area. Of course, Governor Walz saying stay clear of that area. We have more team coverage on this coming up. And a reminder, Metro Blue Line trains, they are not going to be in a service today until further notice due to the riots in place.
All right. Thanks for that update, Alicia. Our coverage of the unrest in Minneapolis continues this morning, including what the police chief says about possibly calling in the National Guard. Then the protesters you've been seeing, not all of them are from Minneapolis. How far one man traveled for justice, and why he says it's a cause that hits close to home. And before we head to break, here are new images coming in this morning. We're sending you to break with the images of the overnight clashes.